This morning in the Rhode Show Kitchen, we are joined by Chef Bob Myers from Oscar's Food Company. We're so excited to have you on. We're making something called bread salad, and for me, the only bread I've ever seen in a salad is when it's a crouton.
Yes. This is my version on a classic Italian dish called panzanella, which is a cold bread salad.
Okay.
What we do is we saute the vegetables, we add the beans to it, and then we toss the bread in at the very end with some type of protein. And it turns out into a wonderful warm dish that can be either an appetizer or a dinner.
Nice. All right, so what are the ingredients that we need for this recipe?
Well, first of all, you need either clarified butter or olive oil.
Okay.
Shallots is one of the main ingredients, and then the vegetables are all pretty much interchangeable. You can use pretty much everything you have in the fridge. You need some bread that's diced up, preferably a day old. Again,
okay.
It's good for using up leftovers.
Yes.
And then we're going to do it with grilled shrimp today, but you could use chicken, you could use steak, you can use sausage, you can use tofu, could be a vegetarian dish. So it's very versatile, and you can make it larger for a dinner.
I was going to say, between the different proteins and the vegetables, you can really kind of create your own.
Absolutely.
Out of this.
Absolutely.
And you were saying this warm version of a bread salad you've been making for how long now?
About 25 years.
Clearly it's a popular
yes,
item
it's very popular.
On the menu.
Quite a few different restaurants, they still have it on the menu.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And something interesting I was reading about your place, you can actually do takeout as well. You can
yes.
come in or you can
we
take
do,
it
we
to
do
go.
Takeout, we do catering, we do a little bit of everything, absolutely.
Excellent, and we're going to do a little bit of cooking coming up in just a little bit. Back to you.
For now, back to the kitchen. Well,
we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. We are here with Oscar's Food Company. Chef Bob is here. We're going to chop. And we have some serious knives.
We have some serious knives here. What we're going to do here, we're trying to make everything bite-sized.
Okay.
So we're going to take the ends off the zucchini.
All right. Got it.
Okay.
Yep.
I'm going to cut it in half all the way down
okay.
like this. I'm going to cut it in half again this way.
Okay. So far, so good.
Okay. And then we're just going to...
So just cube it up.
Just cube it up. Nice
okay.
and easy.
Okay. And you're going to do this to all of the vegetables that we have here?
All the vegetables we have. They're going to do the mushrooms a little bit different, but we'll do the zucchini first, then the tomatoes.
Okay. Now, what if you don't like some of these vegetables?
The
vegetables
are all interchangeable. You can use anything you want. None of the vegetables are critical to the dish.
Are set in stone,
right? Right, exactly. Whatever you have in your garden, whatever you have in your fridge, perfectly fine.
You can use.
Yes.
All right, I got mine chopped up.
All right, very good. Very good. You're doing a good job. And then we'll take the ends off the tomatoes next.
Okay. Chop that down.
Right. Do the same thing. Cut it in half.
Mm-hmm.
Cut it in half again.
Okay.
And then cube it up again.
Okay. Cube all this stuff up.
Right.
Now, this is a great alternative to just a regular salad that you make at home, right?
Correct. This can either be a salad as an appetizer course,
mm-hmm.
or it could also be a main course if you want to.
Okay.
It's kind of hard with the knife sometimes on these tomatoes
right.
here. Then we're going to take the mushrooms.
Yep.
Okay. Cut them in half.
Okay. You're going to leave the stem on?
Leave the stem right
leave the
on.
Stem on it. Okay.
And then just slice them real thin.
Okay. Chop these up. It's all good stuff.
Oh yeah.
And then just everything's going to be put into these bowls or
everything's going to be yeah, the stuff is going to you try and keep the vegetables separate because they go into the salad at different times.
You should have told me that before,
that's
Bob.
That's okay.
That was the one step I missed.
We could separate them. Not a problem.
That was probably a key thing that we probably should have gone through. I'm separating now, Bob.
Okay, all right.
Don't fire me. All right, so we have everything separated. We're going to put everything together. I already did, but we're going to put everything together because I don't follow direction very well. In the meantime, back to you. We're back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Oscar's Food Company is the place. Chef Bob is here. We have chopped up the ingredients. Everything's separated. We are going to get ready to put everything in the pan.
Yes, we're ready to cook
here. Ready to go. All right, let's see what we got to do.
We're going to start out with clarified butter.
Okay.
You can use olive oil. We try and use clarified butter instead of whole butter because it's much healthier. All the fat is taken out of it. So you can substitute olive oil for this if you wish.
Right.
But we try and keep it as healthy
as
possible.
Does the clarified butter give it a better taste?
I like the butter taste, but I don't like to use the whole butter.
Okay.
So we're going to put, these are ground shallots. This is one of the key ingredients of the dish.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're going to do a little bit of black pepper, a little bit of salt.
And why are we using three pans as opposed to just taking everything and tossing it together?
Well, it's
you're not getting too fancy on this, are you?
No. Sometimes when you try and make things in bulk, they don't come out the same as when you're trying to make an individual
okay.
order.
All right.
So we try and cook individual orders as much as possible uh-huh. while we're cooking at Oscar's.
Okay. And how long will these actually have to saute for?
This total dish is about three and a half minutes.
So it's really easy.
It's a really
quick,
simple
it's easy,
dish.
All healthy
something
stuff is
you
in
could
it.
Do at home.
Right.
What we're going to do now is just let these vegetables cook for just about a minute.
Right.
Then we're going to add the next line of vegetables here.
So while we're doing this, tell everybody where you guys are located, because you've only been open for just a short time.
Yep,
right?
We've been open for 2 months. We're on Cohasset Avenue in West Warwick, right in the middle of the shopping center.
Okay.
In the center of Cohasset Avenue.
And as we were saying, it's where the old Riccardi's.
Old Riccardi's, right. Roma Deli used to be. We took over the Roma Deli.
Okay.
And we do a lot of lunch, dinner, takeout. We do dinner service with fine wine
tastings
things at night. We do a lot of different things.
That's good stuff.
Yeah.
So sit here, saute for a little bit.
Yep.
And what do you want the consistency to be? Are they going to get down to like a more tender?
Just a little bit. It depends. It depends on your preference. If you like your vegetables very al dente, you can cook them less.
Okay.
If you like them a little bit more cooked,
right.
You can go a little bit more.
Yeah, I don't like them when they get too like mushy. You know, too
right,
mushy.
Exactly. So this is a very nice dish.
Okay. Put this on here.
So we're going to go into the next line of ingredients here.
All of the stuff you prepared beforehand,
correct.
Making sure it was all cubed
yep.
up.
Yep, carrots were cooked ahead of time.
And you also said that was one of the key things, to make sure they were all bite-sized,
yes.
easy to...
Very easy up. To do. Like the snow peas that we're putting in here will be almost raw at the end. It doesn't take long to do
okay.
this. The vegetables are all interchangeable. The only key ingredients you really need here are the shallots and some type of beans
right.
and the bread.
Okay. But everything else you can really make
everything sure. else you can interchange. Whatever you have in your fridge, whatever you like to use.
Looks, it smells great. It really does. It smells really good.
It's nice and fresh.
Yeah.
It's just, and you can eat it room temperature, you can eat it hot.
Something to do with a lot of, with spring and summer coming, if you have vegetables
right.
in the garden, you can use all the stuff. But if not, can we use the frozen stuff?
You can use the frozen stuff.
If you have to.
You're better using frozen stuff than canned stuff. I would stay away from using any canned stuff.
Okay.
But, I mean, right here, we're using frozen baby peas in here, mm-hmm. and everything else is fresh.
Okay.
I would definitely not use any canned,
right.
canned ingredients in here.
And today, we're going to put shrimp on the dish itself.
Correct.
But you were saying, because, as you know, I'm not a seafood lover, you
right.
could mix it up and you can put anything on it.
Right. We'll make one of these vegetarian today. You can do tofu, you can do sausage, you can do... chicken,
right.
steak, anything you have left over in the fridge, you can chop up and put it on top.
I'll throw it on top.
Yep.
That's enough.
So see how that's starting to come down just a little bit, the
mm-hmm.
vegetables?
Right.
So that's pretty much all you want.
Okay.
You don't
good.
Want to go too much further than this. Then we're going to add the tomatoes. And you can use any kind of beans you'd like in this dish.
Okay.
We like to use cannellini beans.
Mm-hmm.
You can use canned beans. You can use fresh beans. Totally up to you. Whatever you like.
Do these beans have to soak for a little while before you're putting them in?
No.
They don't? Okay.
If you're using fresh beans, what you have to do is you have to save a little bit of the juice, because the little bit of the juice is what makes the little bit of the sauce at the end.
All right. Okay.
That gives you a lot of the flavor here.
Good tip. All right, we just got a couple of seconds left.
Yep. So here we go. We're going to add the bread. We're going to finish it up, and that's going to be it.
Okay. And how long is this going to... With the bread in it, just let it sit there?
That's it. We're going to toss it. We're done.
Okay. Easy enough. All right. Good stuff. We'll show you the finished product in just a little bit. But if you want this recipe so you can make it at home tonight, you can head to our website, WPRI.com. Just click on the Rhode Show.